Hello viewers, any industry, whether it is manufacturing, servicing like banking, insurance, tourism and hospitality or trading involves monetary transactions. At the end of a particular period, if the total money received is more than the total money expended, the business is said to have earned a profit. If the total money received is less than the total money expended, the business is said to have incurred a loss. Every business intends to generate a profit. Therefore, the owners of the business are always interested in knowing the outcome of the business activity. Tourism industry involves the exchange of cash and funds from one person to another person and from one country to another. It is crucial to keep track of such movement of cash and funds in determining the profitability and financial soundness of a business. I welcome you to this episode where we will be discussing on the importance of accounting in tourism industry. For the convenience, the episode is divided into five subheadings, namely introduction to accounting, accounting equation, benefits or advantages of accounting, important terms in accounting. Accounting equation. Let us now understand the concept of accounting through the introduction to accounting. Accounting is a system which measures, records, analyzes, and reports the effect of business transactions and events taking place in a business enterprise. It is a procedure of recording the business transactions in a systematic manner to know the results of the business, that is, profitability and financial position. Definitions of accounting. Accounting has been defined by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, AICPA, as the function of accounting is to provide quantitative information primarily of financial nature about economic entities that is needed to be useful in making economic definitions. In the words of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, ICAI, accounting can be defined as the art of systematic recording, classifying, summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money, transactions and events which are in part at least of financial character and interpreting the results thereof. From the above definitions, we can understand that accounting is the art of recording business transactions in a methodical manner so as to show the true state of affairs of a business at a particular time and also the surplus or deficiency which has accrued during that period. Evolution of accounting. Accounting is an ancient art as old as money itself. Ancient accounting system were followed by the Sumerians, which dated back to 4000 BC, where they recorded the business activities on clay tablets. In India, the book Arthashastra, written by Chanakya, has clearly mentioned about the existence and need for proper accounting and credit. However, the credit for modern system of accounting owes its origin to Luca Pacioli, who lived in Italy in the 15th century. Now, accounting system has attracted the attention of all businessmen and other stakeholders. Accounting and reporting of financial activities has become mandatory for almost all types of business firms, and technology is also added to the modern accounting by way of using computerized accounting system called Tally. Need for accounting. It is extremely important to have the latest information about what is happening in business. This helps in taking appropriate and timely action. The owner of the business, creditor or banker needs to know about the latest financial health of the business for taking suitable decisions about the future course of action. Accounting helps in maintaining and providing the latest financial position of the business and therefore assumes great significance. Accounting is also needed for the following reasons as well. Number one, accounting provides up-to-date information about the business. Number two, accounting reflects the result of transactions made during a period, that is, profits earned or losses incurred. Number three, accounting gives information about the state of affairs of the business at regular intervals. Number four, accounting helps the business in determining the incidence of various taxes. Number five, accounting helps to analyze the performance of the business. Number six, accounting helps comparing the performance of several business firms. Users of accounting information. The accounting information of the business is required by various interested persons. They are the owners, customers, and trade debtors, prospective investors, suppliers or creditors, managers, employees, government, etc. They depend on the information provided in the financial statements prepared by accounting department and approved by an auditor for taking various decisions pertaining to their activities. Let us now discuss each of them one by one. Number one, owners. The first interested persons are the owners. Owners have invested funds in the business by way of capital and other means. Therefore, they are interested in accounting information to know whether the funds are being properly used or not, and what is the financial position of the business. Number two, banks and other financial institutions. Banks and other financial institutions who lend money to a business firm are the interested persons of accounting information required to know whether loans can be granted to the firm and that amount of loan and interest will be paid by the firm when due date arrives. Number three, customers and trade creditors. The third interested persons are the customers and trade creditors. Customers and trade creditors require information about the ability of the business to survive and prosper. As customers of the company's products, they have a long-term interest in the company's range of products and services. They may even be dependent on the business for certain products or services. Number four, prospective investors. The fourth interested persons are the prospective investors. They are the persons who want to invest money in the business firm. Before investing, they are interested in knowing the past and present performance of the firm by going through audited accounting information. Number five, suppliers or creditors. The fifth interested persons are the suppliers or the creditors. Creditors are the persons who have given money or supplied goods and services to the business. They are always interested in getting back the principal amount with some amount of interest. Therefore, they see accounting records to know the progress and day-to-day working of the business. Number six, managers. The sixth users of accounting information are the managers of the business firm. Managers are interested in accounting information to know their performances in the business and take necessary action in running the business efficiently. Number seven, employees. The next users of accounting information are the employees. The bread and butter of the employees depend upon the earnings of the business firm. Employees are also entitled to receive bonus, which depends upon the profits earned by the firm. Hence, employees are interested in the accounting information. Number eight, government. The other interested person is the government. Government is interested in accounting information of the firm in ascertainment of income tax, sales tax, excise duty, customs duties and other taxes. The main benefits of accounting are: systematic recording of all business transactions will be possible through accounting. Accounting provides a complete record of what a firm owns and owes and what is the amount invested, so that the business will know the financial position quickly and easily. Accounting helps in determining the profit or loss for a specific period. Accounting helps the businessman in making future decisions. Accounting provides the detailed information about the business to the stakeholders, investors, and other interested parties, as we have discussed earlier. Frauds and misappropriations can be detected through the use of accounting system. Progress of the firm can be known by comparing the accounting statements of 2 or more years. Accounting system enables the management to control the activities of the business. Accounting helps in assessment of taxes payable by the firm. Limitations of accounting. Though there are more important advantages of accounting, there exist certain limitations. They are: number one, accounting records only monetary transactions. Non-monetary transactions, though they might be important for the business, are ignored. Number two, accounting records only historical data of costs and revenues, that is, it does not provide information about the changes in the market value of assets, the prevailing market factors, etc. Number three, in accounting, expenses are not classified as direct and indirect to show the controllable and uncontrollable items. Number four, accounting does not provide the complete and detailed analysis of losses. Meaning of debit and credit in accounting. An account is a T-shaped statement in which all the transactions pertaining to one person or one thing are recorded for the given period. The left-hand side of the account is called the debit side and the right-hand side is called the credit side. When we say a transaction is to be debited, it means that we need to show the accounting entry which has resulted either in an increase in an asset or expense account, or decrease in a liability or in the capital account. It is positioned on the left hand side, that is debit side of an account. An item is to be credited means that the entry has either resulted in an increase with respect to liability or capital account, or a decrease with respect to an asset or expense account. Double entry system of accounting. The concept of accounting is based on the principle that every business transaction has two folded effects, which are exactly opposite to each other. A business transaction can have two effects, that is, debit and credit, and they are always equal. As a result, at the end of the accounting period, the accounts should tally, meaning that both total debits and total credits should register equal amounts. There are prescribed rules for debiting and crediting various accounts, which are classified under three major groups. These rules form the basis of accounting under double entry bookkeeping system. Before we discuss in detail the various aspects of accounting, let us know some of the important basic terms in accounting. Let us confer them one by one. Number one, business transaction. A business transaction is an agreement between two parties under which goods and services are exchanged for money or money's worth. For example, goods sold, purchase of goods, payment of expenses, etc. Number two, entity. Entity refers to a thing or person having a definite separate existence. A business is regarded as an independent entity for the purpose of accounting. Assets. Assets mean any property or things owned by a business which is expressible in terms of money. Assets are further divided into fixed assets, which include land, buildings, plant and machinery, furniture and fixtures, etc., and current assets, which include cash in hand and cash at bank, stock of goods, trade debtors, bills receivable, etc. Liabilities. Liabilities are the amount or debts due by the firm to others. Debts arise due to purchase of assets or goods on credit. Liabilities are divided into fixed liabilities like debentures and other long-term loans, which carry fixed rate of interest till their redemption, and current liabilities, which arise in day-to-day business activities such as trade creditors, bills payable, outstanding expenses, etc. Capital. Capital is the amount of money or money's worth invested by the proprietor into the business. Capital may be further divided into two parts, namely fixed capital. It is the huge amount of money invested in the fixed assets of a firm, and working capital, the amount of money invested in current assets and used for meeting the day-to-day expenditure of a business. Drawings. Drawings are the cash or goods or any other thing withdrawn by the owner from the business for his personal use. Such drawings are to be deducted from the capital invested by the owner. Credit transaction. A credit transaction is a transaction in which goods are sold or purchased, but the receipt or payment of cash is postponed to the specified dates in future. Goods. Goods refer to the products or commodities or articles in which the businessman is dealing. For example, chairs, sofas, tables, and carts are termed as goods for a furniture vendor. Similarly, car, spare parts of cars, accessories of cars are termed as goods for a car manufacturer. Stock. There is a difference between goods and stock. As we discussed above, goods refer to the commodities sold by the business firms, whereas stock represents the unsold amount of goods lying in the godown or stores of the business firm is termed as stock. Account. An account is a T-shaped statement in which all transactions pertaining to one person or one thing are recorded for the given period. The left-hand side of the account is called the debit side, and the right-hand side is called the credit side. The name of the person or thing is written at the top of the account. It is represented by A bar C. Journal. A journal is a book of original entry in which all the business transactions and their effect on the concerned accounts are recorded. Ledger. A ledger is an accounting book which facilitates the transfer of all business transactions in a chronological order to individual accounts. Folio. Folio is the page of a journal or ledger. Carried down. Carried down is written in the ledger account at the time of its closure to indicate that the balance of that account has been carried down to the next period. Its short form is used as C bar D. Brought down. It is written in the ledger account at the time of its opening to indicate that the balance of that account has been brought down from the previous period. Its short form is B bar D. Carried forward. Carried forward is used at the foot of the page of a ledger to indicate that the total amount of that page has been carried over to the next page. Its short form is used as C bar F. Brought forward. Brought forward is used at the head of the page of a ledger to indicate the total amount of the previous page has been brought forward. Its short form is B bar F. Expenses. Expenses are the costs incurred for generating the income. They are recurring in nature, for example, salary, wages, interest paid, etc. Losses. Losses are the costs incurred without any benefit being received. They are accidental or non-recurring in nature. Examples are goods destroyed by fire, loss on sale of assets, etc. Incomes. Income is the amount received or receivable from the sale of goods and services or assets. For example, goods sold for cash, sale of buildings, etc. Gains. A gain is an excess of revenue over expenditure or an increase in the value of an asset or cash received without incurring any liability. Receipts. Receipts are the counterfoils or carbon copies of receipts issued for receipt of an amount. Such counterfoils receipts can also be received when the payments are made. Vouchers. Vouchers are the written documents used as documentary evidence in support of an entry appearing in the books of accounts. For example, cash memo, salary bill, wage bill, invoice, etc. The accounting equation, also called as the balance sheet equation, forms the foundation for all accounting systems. This simple equation illustrates two facts about a business firm: what it owns and what it owes. The accounting equation equates a firm's assets to its liabilities and the owner's capital. This shows all assets of a business concern are acquired by either debt or capital. For example, when a business is started, its assets are first purchased with either cash, the received forms of loans, or by the capital invested by its owner. The equation is assets is equal to liabilities plus owner's capital. As we can see, assets equal the sum of liabilities and owner's capital. This makes sense when you think about it, because liabilities and capital are essentially just sources of funding for companies to purchase assets. The equation is generally written with liabilities appearing before the owner's capital, because creditors usually have to be repaid before investors in case of winding up of the business. This equation holds true for all business activities and transactions. Assets will always equal to liabilities and owner's capital. If assets increase, either liabilities or owner's capital must increase to balance out the equation. The opposite is true if liabilities or capital increases. To sum up, accounting is defined as the art of recording, classifying, summarizing the business transactions in a significant manner and in terms of money or money's worth, and interpreting the results. Accounting is as old as money itself. The origin of accounting can be traced back to 4000 BC. Accounting is most important for all types of business concerns. Through accounting, it is possible to determine the profitability and financial position of a business for a particular period. There are various uses of accounting information: owners, banks and other financial institutions, customers and creditors, prospective investors, suppliers, managers, employees, government, etc. Accounting has several advantages. It facilitates systematic recording of business transactions, provides a complete record of all the things which a firm owns and owes, and helps in determining profit or loss for a particular period. It also helps in detection of frauds and misappropriations and in comparing the financial positions of two or more years. Accounting suffers from certain limitations too. which includes omission of non-monetary transactions, not providing information about the current market values of assets and other market factors, etc. An account is a T-shaped statement in which the left-hand side is called the debit side and the right-hand side is known as the credit side, and the transactions are entered in the respective columns. The rule of debit and credit states that every business transaction has two effects, and it is possible to find the accuracy by tallying the debits and credits of a statement. The accounting equation is also called the balance sheet equation, which is the foundation for all accounting systems. It equates a firm's assets to its liabilities and the owner's capital.